इतना सफर है कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में, इतना सा फर्क है एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन के कवर पेज पे होने में, इतना सा ही तो फर्क है वीआईपी सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में, इतना सा ही तो फर्क है। वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है। इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकपुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है। ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है। एक कदम, एक छलांग, एक बाजी, एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के, कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क है। धूप छाओं में फर्क बस इतना सा है। तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं। फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया, 20 years of ideas.
Good afternoon, one and all. Franchise India brand, which is creating difference with all the initiatives which we take. The initiative which we have taken on 1st of May was Business Opportunity with Chai Series. And we welcome you to the 103rd edition of this particular webinar. Our aim is to provide you all the business opportunities through which you can select your dream brands. We welcome you to this particular webinar, which is hosted by Mr. Maria, who is a founder and chairman at Franchise India Group, along with our second panel member, she is Sonia Chaudhary, and she is the MD at Franchise India Brands Limited. And both are leading a team of business consultants, helping brands to expand their business with our 70 plus offices and business buyers to get their dream brands. Today, they are sharing their insights, views about the industry, as well as about the brand. And today, the brand of the day is Dogobo, and we have Ibadat Sharma and Ms. Nimisha Sharma talking about this great brand. The brand which is known for its international standards, they are the one-stop solution, luxury one-stop solution for all your pet needs. But before I formally invite them for the presentation, we request Nimisha to play a small video for all our investors.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ibadat and Nimisha, for joining us today. You can share your screen and your business model.
Can you see the presentation on your laptop right now?
Yes.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Sonia ma'am. Thank you for joining in. So Dogogo is mainly a pet clothing and apparel manufacturers. We are basically manufacturers of pet clothing and apparels and accessories. Apparels range from anywhere from sherwanis to frocks to t-shirts. And accessories are the basic necessities like collars. As you can see, we divide Dogogo into clothing, accessories, products and grooming. Accessories, collars, leashes, harnesses that you need on a day-to-day basis to walk your pet. Clothing are also utility, but all mostly related to when you want to go on, even you want to dress your pet up. Products range from anywhere from treats to shampoos to toys to the main pet food. And grooming is, like you saw in the video, it is mainly about giving your pet a bath, giving your pet a haircut, which is also a very important part of their upkeep and their hygiene and for the longevity of the lifespan. Moving on, like you already know about, which has already been explained, that Dogogo is a Hyderabad-based organization. Although we have a retail store, a luxury retail store, but we are mainly manufacturers of pet products. The first one we talks about a well-established brand which deals with accessories and clothing. I've already explained about that. Catering to the pet lovers through a retail store, not just in India, not just Hyderabad, but globally. This talks about the market that we have, not just in India, but abroad, that the customers want the Indian prints, the Sherwanis, the brocade prints, the Ikat prints, which are not available abroad. They source it from India, and we are like a one-stop shop for them to shop from. And it's a professionally managed, mainly by us. We ourselves are pet parents. We have three dogs amongst us, and we understand the challenges faced by a pet parent, the needs of a pet parent, and we can connect with them easily, and that is why we present products to them which a pet parent would generally require. And this is like a formal invitation to all the investors sitting out there to join us in helping the business, growing this business. Moving on, like you can see, as was also visible in the video, that the image on the top left is the store. It's not a contemporary store, not a contemporary 250 square feet store. It is a very hygienic store. This is exactly the store. This is exactly what the store looks like at the moment as well. And it always looks like this. We have about 177 reviews on Google, and we find multiple reviews talking about the hygiene which is maintained in the pet store. Pets are allowed in the store. So of course they soil the area. We have a dedicated staff which makes sure that, of course you cannot stop a pet from soiling the area, but let's not hinder the experience of the pet parent who's there to shop with us. So that is the image on the left, and everything else is the products that Dogogo has created, including everything in the video. None of the products are something that we've outsourced. Everything is what we make right here in Hyderabad. Moving on, inception of Dogogo, which Nimisha will be taking over.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for having us here today. So basically, Dogogo started when I'm the founder of Dogogo. So I went to US. That is where I saw that there's so many products that are offered for pet parents, and pet parents, they like, there's different products like collars, leashes, harnesses, there are malls for pets in which there are ramps for pets and beds, and there's so much variety over there that right now India doesn't have that. India is like an untapped market, and that is when I realized that we should bring that in India, and we should have that like here as well. So that is when I had the idea of starting something like having a luxury pet store and having like a pet clothing segment that will be like our major selling point here. So that is how it started. Initially started from one room where I used to get the clothing and all stitched for some of my friends and the family and everyone. And that is when I started putting it up on Instagram and selling my products. Slowly it started, it went from one room to one floor in my building itself. And then after it came to the store. So we have grown rapidly, and I have seen a lot of growth in the pet clothing that sells. So the pet parents is what we've realized are like, if you have a pet, you will definitely spend on them. So that is the aim. And they want to dress their pets up. And why not? Like, it is also not just for the look and all, it's also for the utility. So we also have raincoats, and we have different products catering to different seasons for that. So that is how Dogobo started, actually.
To give you a brief idea, I'm hoping, or it's more about, I'm certain that approximately about 10% of the total people watching this live seminar right now have pets at home. So, but to others who are probably not aware of the pet industry, these are just basic facts. Because of rapid urbanization and the rising increase of nuclear families, people are now adopting pets a lot more. Because, of course, you are a smaller family, and while a pet is not as much of a maintenance as probably having a kid is. So a lot of nuclear families are now adopting pets. And because of course of the current situation with coronavirus hitting us, a lot of people confining to their homes, we have seen a major increase in the number of people adopting pets. And there is a shortage. There are no pets available for people to now adopt, because the market is almost saturating when it comes to the adopting pets part of it. And as of July 2019, India has about 23 million dogs and 4 million cats as pets. And just like how Prime Minister Modi addressed in yesterday's Mann Ki Baat about adopting Indian breeds more as compared to the breeds of the other breeds present, we have about 6 lakh pet adoptions that take place every single year. Which is, again, rising. This is all data as per 2019. A lot more people adopting the indies, as we call it. And talking about the growth of the current scenario of the pet industry, as opposed or on contrary to the let's say the Latin American or the European market, India is now the next stop for the highest growth in the pet industry. There is a cumulative average growth rate of about 20%, which is projected for 2018 to 2024, because these are markets where a lot of international players, such as Champion Foods, which owns Origin and Akana, which is mainly, again, a premium segment of pet food. There are a lot of other brands will come to it as we move on in the later slides. They are now entering the Indian market. There's a brand called Kong. It's a US-based brand. They are now setting their foot in India. So they are now, India is the next place. And that holds true for a lot of markets, be it automobile or whatever. A lot of India is now being identified as the next market for the pet industries to take over. So there's about a 20% growth rate for the pet industry. And although we are a pet retail, and I keep stressing about this, that we are mainly manufacturers of pet products. And we pride ourselves about it because... going back to the 10% pet parents which are probably watching this right now, we all know that the most of the pet products are not made in India. They all come from abroad. China has a major chunk of this, and with the current motion going on about vocal for local, we pride ourselves on telling people that we manufacture these products with great quality. We make certain products like harnesses and leashes, which are extremely pivotal on a day-to-day basis. The strength, the utility, it cannot snap. You cannot take your pet out for a walk. It cannot snap. Your pet is out on the road. We make products which hold big, huge dogs to like small toy breeds. So talking about that, pet apparel industry is expected to see a growth rate of 17% from 2019 to 2027, with more and more people adopting clothing for pets. One second. Yes, so next, the general idea of the services and products offered by Doggable, pet products and accessories, which I've been talking about, accessories which include collars, leashes, sherwanis. Pet products is everything from food bowls to treats. That is one thing that Doggable offers as a retail store. Pet food products, again, mentioned there. Pet grooming and apparels. This is one section we completely own. We have our own in-house grooming. We have in-house groomers available who provide grooming services to dogs, and of course, our parents part of it.
I'm going to tell you about the products that we offer here, that we manufacture at Doggable. There are around 250 SKUs that we have. So I couldn't list everything in this slide, but I'll just give you a gist of it. So pet essentials are basically the collars and leashes. That are the essential products for every pet that has to be leashed, or, you know, we have different collar, that is martingale collar or paraband collar or normal buckle collars. So there are, and bow collars. So these are the different collars that we have. In leashes, we have padded and non-padded leashes. So mostly all the materials used are cotton, so that, you know, because of Indian climate, the fabric should be very suitable for the pet. And as it's not very cold in India, so we use material that is very pet friendly and it won't affect the pet in any way. The other category is pet accessories, in which bandanas, ties, Peter Pan collars, bows. Then we have neck tutus and different accessories, basically. Then the next point is pet harnesses. Pet harnesses also ideally comes under pet essentials, which is also very important for pets. So in this, we have step-in harness, edge harness, overhead harness, body harness. Most of them are padded. Even in the image, like you can see, it has a small padded patch in the front for the comfort of the pet. So then after that, we have pet clothing. In pet clothing, we have frocks, tuxedos, hoodies, jumpsuit, capes, costumes, tank tops, sherwanis, and a lot more. And we customize every clothing and as per the pet size. Like I said earlier, we also have clothing for the safety purposes, like for to protect the pet. So we have raincoats as well. In raincoats, we also have different types, that is body suit, body wrap, and overhead raincoat. According to, because not all pets are very comfortable with clothing, so we have complicated garments as well as the simple ones that are easy to wear, so that the pet doesn't feel very uncomfortable while wearing it. If the owner wants their pet to, if the pet parent wants to dress their pet up, then they can go ahead with some bandana or some, you know, easy to wear clothing. So we have both the segments. We have the complicated garments as well as the very basic, easy moving products. The last one is the pet beds. One of the most moving segments as well. Round bed, rectangle bed, crown bed, sofa bed. We also have floor mats, that are just the mats that come on the floor. So these are the different pet products that we manufacture right here in Hyderabad. Like I said, most of the products are all cotton, or depends on the material. Like we also have brocade, or we have like this Garboni Choli collection that was again of cotton, but with embroidery embossed on it. So all these materials are very soft. It doesn't affect the pet in any way.
All right. So now talking about the key USPs of Doggable, and why you should invest, why you should take up a franchise here, Doggable, is we will move on to the next slide, but if you just look at this slide, you will see a variety of products. One is a bow, and the other are harnesses, but there are two different types of harnesses. All these products have been made after, like I said, we have three pets amongst ourselves. We have a lot of dedicated client base. So all these products have been made after testing and sampling on our own pets, after taking on multiple walks, after a lot of testing has been put into it. And of course, a lot of innovation is brought into this. So you can see a lot of variety, but now we go on to the actual USPs, the key USPs of the brand. Customization. To give you an idea, you walk into a pet store right away, you'll probably see basic black, green, white, not white, but probably black, green, blue, leashes, harnesses, main basic products. And people want to migrate from that now. You don't have to pay a premium to get that. You just need to think different And that is where we bring in different prints in the already existing products. For example, on the left, we have the bow collar being worn by Samantha Akineni ma'am's pet hash. Samantha Akineni ma'am is from the Akineni clan of the Tollywood film industry. The pet's name is Hash Akineni. So we have a hashtag hand embroidered on it. We have a crown bed, a typical bed, like Nimisha mentioned, beds, one of the segments is you'll always find a bed in any pet parent's house. Bed is essential, but a small tweak to it, adding a crown shape around it. This not just adds a look, but some pets like to snuggle. Some pets like a protection when their eye layer is covered by a certain level of protection. They want to be snuggled up. So this also adds to that. Plus, there's a name mentioned over there, Toby. And on the bottom, you can see the pet wearing a sherwani, which has a pink print to it, which was, so this is a typical request we get from clients on a very regular basis or to match their outfits for the big day. So a lot of times sherwanis and frocks which move, they want to be matched with the outfit. So that is, again, customization is one important aspect. Second, something we pride ourselves about is in-house manufacturing. Every single product that is made. Now, why this is a key USP to anyone who's looking to invest in Doggo and take up a franchise is because what separates you apart is you get the Doggo specific prints only in Doggo stores. You do not get these anywhere. These prints are handpicked from all over the country. We personally go, a team personally goes and picks the prints. We innovate. A lot of, we've let's say 20 prints, out of which two, we boil down to two. And that is how we boil down to the prints that are selected. So in-house manufacturing, everything is made right here at this at the manufacturing unit. Grooming service, very important. People always wonder why the pet clothing or pet grooming is on the pricier side. You get a haircut, you walk into a human salon, you get a haircut for 250, 300 rupees. You go to a premium one, you probably get it at 900, 850 rupees. Why are pets' haircuts important? Mainly because they have big sharp teeth. They can bite you. The groomer needs to be really skilled. Our groomers are trained in handling a pet. There are certain places you hold a pet wherein the pet is under control. The groomer, the pet needs to know who's in control. So we have the grooming services in a way that the pets, we know the pet's going to go crazy in these when we put water on him, when you use a blow dryer, they're very sensitive noise. So they cannot have any sharp edges. They cannot have any points where they can just fall off the grooming table. Like you can see, there's a leash hanging from the tables which keeps the pet in place. We have silent dryers which make sure that the pet is not irritated by the loud noises. So that is why there's a the grooming service needs to be absolutely premium, and a premium needs to be paid for the same, because there's a lot more care and detail and goes into pet grooming. Third, again, all USPs are, I cannot point them down to 1, 2, 3. They're all at 1, 1, 1, because they're all interconnected and they cannot be downplayed. Innovation of products is, again, what keeps the Doggo brand running. We have a team here, we have a team of 20 here, which sits and decides what product needs to be made, what material to be used. A typical simple t-shirt cannot be worn on a pet. Their fine hair can get stuck into that. That leads to various other skin diseases. So innovation of products. We periodically innovate new products for utility and for comfort and for the look, so that the Doggo brand is never stale. You always come into the store with new products, and of a new franchisee always has a new product to show to the customer. And people expect, although with certain products like food and shampoos, they stick to a certain brand, but when it comes to clothing and harnesses, they want new things to try. So that is why innovation is very important. And the other important aspects of which are specific to our brand along with others are high customer retention. we have a 65% customer retention right now, which is highly unlikely for a pet industry. Again, for all the pet parents sitting out there, pet stores or pet retail stores are mainly, the success depends on the proximity of a pet store to the pet parent. People will not venture out to a pet store which is very far away as long as they can get their food close by. So customers switch from one pet store to another in a jiffy. But we have a 65% customer retention, mainly because of the customer service provided. Hygienic shopping environment, pet soils area, instant cleaning. We have products which ensure that which pet probably doesn't pee there. We also give the pet the freedom to pee. We do not stop. We do not put the pressure on the pet, but we keep the area clean. We cater to a wide range of products, income group. Although we, yes, we are a luxury brand, but we have a product, a shampoo, which is 350 rupees for a 300 ml and 875 rupees for a 275 ml. Again, both the products are good, but you want to cater to both the kind of markets because pet parents or pets are adopted by start from lower middle class to higher middle to let's say the super rich. So that is the range. Periodic innovation products, which we've already talked about, very important to keep the store, to keep the brand fresh. Accountability of the products, very important here. You buy a leash, you buy a collar, we won't talk about the clothing part of this. Accountability mainly deals with you buy a pet, you buy a leash, you buy a collar, you go out on the pet, it snaps, you go to the pet store and the pet store owner says, this is not my product, it comes from outside, I can't do anything about it. The product breaks, you get it back to us. Although it has never happened, there's any issue with the product, get it back to us. We will brainstorm over this, why this happened, we'll replace it, we'll give it to you, but we'll make sure it never happens again. We created right here. So we use, we already tested before. You can always get the products back to us. If in cases of it breaks, we will fix it for you. Personal attention to every customer. As we move on to the breakup of the amount, the set of the total cost, we will also talk about the staff required. We at least have one person attending to every customer. Like, of course, not every customer can be given individual attention at all points of time, but we switch. We have, let's say, five customer time, we switch from one customer to another. We make sure that every customer attended to, as opposed to how a typical pet store is. Customer walks in, they know what they want, they take it and they go. But you want the customer to know more about the products available for their pet. And again, something which is specific, which matters to every anyone who wants to invest, is the higher profit margins. We have about 35% to 55% profit margins on almost 95% of the products. Now coming to the financial model, area required is 650 square feet, as opposed to the typical pet store, which you see probably built in at 200, 250, 300 square feet. This 650 square feet will need to have 100 square feet or 80 square feet of a grooming room. So that that is an identity that needs to be carried along the Doggo pet stores. The approximate investment required is 30 lakhs, about 29 lakhs, 50,000, which includes out of which 5 lakhs are franchise fee. And everything else is based on actuals, which talks about, which includes the interiors. We want the interior. Now there's a focus on the interiors at Doggo, the color scheme, the kind of display we have. It includes the grooming equipments and so on. There's a royalty of 6% on the products, although there's a different royalty, a lower royalty on pet food because of the certain margins. Like I said, there's 95% margin on 35. There's a 35 to 55% profit margin on 95% of the products. The rest of the things, the 5% caters to the pet foods, where the royalty is lower than 6%. Average payback period right now is of 2 years, 6 months, wherein you recover the entire cost. And the agreement term, we want to build a brand with you, want to grow the brand with you. And we obviously vet our the people who want to invest in Doggo won't take up. So we ourselves vet them. So we want to be a big family. So we want it to be at least a 5-year agreement. The breakdown, which I already gave a gist of in the last slide, infrastructure cost, the ACs, the architecture fee, everything, the signage cost comes up to around 6 lakhs. But again, this is all based on the actuals. You have your own interior, somebody who does interior. You have your own interior designing company. You have your own contacts. Now, the layout will be given by us. But please go ahead. You're free to get your interiors done from your own contacts. The equipment cost, outlet equipments, which includes from the barcode machine to the ID tag machine, wherein we engrave the name of the pet, which is essential in today's times. If the pet runs, there's a phone number, there's a name mentioned. The machine itself costs 4 lakh rupees. There's the grooming equipments, the drying table, the bathtub, the blowers, the silent dryers, everything, the CCTVs, comes up to around 8,60,000. Business promotions, licensing, initial stock, which includes retail, mainly runs on the stock, the storage and the stock required, it's about 8,50,000. And the launch and marketing cost is about 1 lakh, wherein we try to, the marketing, what we can provide the marketing right now are, we have a strong following on Instagram. We've run sponsored ads on Instagram, Google, Facebook. We, on a feasibility basis, we see if we can run certain ads in Times of India. We have a good tie-up with the local, with the Times of India in Hyderabad, and we can run good ads in the newspaper itself based on the feasibility, on the size of the ad. And we have a existing customer base. We have SMS marketing, wherein we push our existing customer base. It's a one-year-old retail store. We have a huge customer base, and we, as I said, we have a 65% retention. We direct them to your store to give you a great start. You start the bank, and the franchise fee, which is at about 5 lakhs. This slide is included. This slide has been included in this presentation mainly because of the first point. It talks about the average ticket size. This is of a pet store. The average ticket size right now is at 1,093 rupees. Mainly because pet grooming itself takes up, you can walk in the pet, you spend easily end up spending about 2,500, 3,000 rupees. Our clothing, apparels, apparels again add to a major chunk of the ticket size. And of course, we have the low income, low value products such as shampoos and treats, 250, 350, 550, that caters. So we have a good ticket size of 1,093 rupees. We have an average walk-ins of about 450 to 550 a month, which is, again, most of these are retention customers who are returning back. And when you have a customer who has been retained, they buy a lot more, they want to try a lot more. And like you can see, the revenue division, pet dog treats, other, we have face masks that we make over here because we have we are cotton masks, so they're comfortable. That also adds. We have pet food, which adds to a major chunk, pet dog toys and pet apparels. So these are the revenue division. One second.
I'm so sorry. Just
we have
a
poll that we need to address. To conclude it, this is the overall look and feel. Probably when you're out there tomorrow or going out on a weekend, have a look. If you happen to go to pet store, you will be able to tell the difference between this pet store and a different pet store, and that is what we're trying to create here. And if allowed, you can walk in right now to the pet store, or we can show you the pet store around. It is exactly in the same condition. It is always in the same condition. If not this, go up to our Google reviews. You'll definitely find 2-3 reviews in that where they talk about the hygiene of the pet store. This is a gist of what Dogobo is. And this is what we have to present today.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Really appreciate. And we have seen a lot of work being done in the pet grooming space and pet store space. I think you're the finest from an execution viewpoint, and also being an integrated operator. And I want to really give some perspective to people, you know, who understand the space. The space is very wide, from the from a basic pet stores, which only does largely sell commodity product, which is pet food. pet food is a very highly commoditized product and very low margin. The real business really comes in accessories and a lot of other consumables which people use. And grooming becomes a very important and high margin business. But then you're dealing with a very different kind of clientele. You're dealing with people who also need that kind of a service levels, capabilities, and so on and so forth. And environments where, you know, people who are dog lovers or pet lovers, they would come and they can enjoy that experience being part of that. And that experience is very, very different. So it's a great job done. I think very well placed. So let's start with some few questions which we want to really take up, and you know, we will see a lot of questions coming in Q&A box. And people, I would also request our audience, which is there, that if you have any particular question, just go on a Q&A box and ask, and Sonia and I will take it up. So starting with the business model, while you are integrated, you've given also the breakup of different SKUs and structures in your entirety. Can you explain a little more in detail in terms of what is the category mix currently? What is the category mix for percentage wise mix for you from a sales viewpoint?
Yes.
So the different products, the categories that we have are mainly, like I'll just show you on the slide. Sorry, 1 minute.
Yeah, this is the slide.
Yeah. It's basically divided into dog treats, pet apparel, pet food, dog toys. Just a minute. And other pet products as well. So face mask is something that we started recently just because of the whole COVID situation. And even that is moving really well. Pet apparel and pet clothing is what we do basically right here. That which the franchisor will basically, the franchisee will basically have a margin. We'll be giving those products on a margin. So those, the margin that will be given is around 42.18%. That is the distributor margin that we provide. And that is the highest margin. On other products, the other products will be given on the actual. So the client will have to, the investor will have to directly deal with the distributor. Royal Canin Pedigree or ABK, Origin, Akona. So they'll have to directly deal with them on the original margin that they get. So
but, there is also slabs these companies would give if you are buying at a certain level. Say Royal Canin would give you a higher slab. But exactly. Would it not be sensible to really buy for you at a corporate level, buy while the deliveries can be done from there, but you can really get a higher slab? Because the difference is they have very different slabs for a chain store and individual stores. And a group buying, you can get a better benefit for the franchisees.
Yes, correct. So we have already spoken to the direct distributors regarding this, and like Gaurav sir just said, there are better slabs on the other products as well because we'll be buying it in a group, but it'll be distributed to different sections. But yes, like sir said, it will be like,
so it's a very good option because what they're doing is that they're giving a pass to the maximum margin which you get from all the distribution alignment. So all the distribution alignment they would be able to provide. Some core products like apparel, which is their strength area and which is actually the highest margin business in the structure, if you really see, at about 42%, is directly coming from them. So it's a problem I've seen in a lot of other companies who have started franchising. They actually are just traders. They don't produce anything. So because you are a trader, you are not able to pass margin. And later franchisee says, why should I then be your franchisee if I can buy the same product from outside? Also, the dependability on supply chain, the consistency of the product, all that becomes a very big worry. So what they have really done is, which I think is exceptional, is that they've created the backend part of it, been ready, and now they can support this. So next question to you is, which is the markets? Obviously, you said Hyderabad. Hyderabad is a very big market for this. But any other markets which are key focus for you at this moment?
Well, sir, I honestly, although we want to target, there's no limitation. I feel tier 2 cities is where our product should really be present, because there is money there. There is people want to spend, but the product is not available there. So cities like Nagpur, Bhubaneswar, this is where we would like to ideally be present. Of course, we obviously want to be in the major Bombay, Delhi, but I think it would be a lot more wiser if we were to enter these markets, because the luxury pet retail anyways is a very new market. we could be the Zomatos or the Swiggies of these market if we start at the right time. And currently, considering that because of the current pandemic, the retail prices are at a dead cheap right now, and you can get a retail space in a lot more lower price as compared to what you would get probably a year back. And the same thing applies for a tier two city as well. The renting part goes down a lot more. So I think tier two cities is where we would definitely like to capture. But of course, our focus does not shift from Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, Kolkata.
You're bang on. And I think you rightly said the luxury pet business, pet store business is one only limited to these big cities. And also, if you look at it, there would be not more than 20-25 stores which would define themselves in the luxury space. And they are largely based out of these cities, big cities. There's Delhi, Bombay, maybe Bangalore and Pune and likes of them. But you are absolutely right. From a opportunity viewpoint, I would say Bhuvaneshwars and Nagpur, as you said, Vizag, places like that would play a very important role, and a very large demand side is created, and much more loyalty would come in. And once you open up there, there is no competition. Another thing which is very important in this business or specialty retail largely is that the neighborhoods you choose are essentially residential. You don't have to be in the main market. You are in the residential area. In the residential area, if you are able to get a good 600-650 kind of a square feet, you might in a smaller city can get a 25,000-30,000 rupees rental also. But you can beautifully do it. If you have a little outdoor area, you can also do that. You can build your own aesthetics like they have done it. So it is, becomes an environment where people continue to come, and they come for various reasons. And as I said, the overall pet population by adoption is growing year on year. India is still one of the lowest in the world. So the only way it can go is up. And I think that way the opportunity becomes very, very interesting. And especially if I would say, if you are yourself a pet lover, if you are a pet lover, I've realized that people in this business are always done well. If they are also there themselves enthusiast and they believe in that, then they kind of become a club. They know everybody there, and that's how the relationship really converts into a long-term business model. So any of our audience which is now thinking of being, they also have that same kind of liking, they would do very well in this business. They would. I've always seen almost everybody who has been very successful has been a pet lover himself or herself, and they would be able to do that. Now I'd like to invite Sonia to take question. I will take one question from Venkat, which is important question, because when you give apparel and all these products, there is a lot of issues of slow moving or dead stock. So what do you do on that? I mean, because especially because pet food is no problem. Pet food is like it flies. But other things has sometimes a dead stock or a slow moving stock. What do you do that?
Right. So because we are manufacturers ourselves, and the first month is when we expect the pet the franchise owner to realize what moves and what doesn't move, and they get a fair bit of an idea. And so that is why if in case something doesn't move, they tell us what doesn't move. We replace it with something that moves. So they can give it back to us. Let's say if it's a Sherwani, it's a summer season, people aren't going to go for a Sherwani right now. We take a lot of Sherwanis, get it back. Probably take a bandana, probably take a jersey knit tank top, which is definitely a good time for people to get, not probably Sherwani right now. So to answer the question, yes, you can bring the products back to us. We anyways need a good amount of stocking up to do. There's always a wedding season coming up in November, between September, December, typically. No problem. We'll store it for you, and you can get it, take it whenever you want.
Sure.
Sir, I wanted to just answer the question that you had asked initially regarding the segmentation of what each, the percentage. Sorry, it took me a little time to run my mail. So we have dog toys, and these are all cumulatively, but these have been majorly affected, like the figures have gone up and down after the pandemic. Dog toys are at about 2.4%. Dog treats are 10.5%. Grooming is at 8.6%. Face masks at 1.6%. Pet accessories are at 11.3%. Pet apparels are at 19.7%. Pet cosmetics, which includes shampoos and everything, are at 2.8%. Pet food is at 25%, mainly because We were one of the few stores which were opened March, April, May, as we came under the pet essentials section. So there was never really a time when we had to keep it shut. And because of the whole idea that the street, the indies were suffering, we saw a lot of people going for 20 kg bags of pet food, 20, 15 kg bags, buying in bulk. And how a typical your typical retail store probably witnessed a huge rise in number of people opting for the basic necessities. Similarly, people were buying pet food in bulk. So we saw a huge rise in the pet food, that's about 25%. And the other pet products like bowls, cages, and so on are at 17%.
Which is very good. I mean, I should compliment you. And other smaller stores, if you go and see their books, they would look like 70-80% only on food. So yes, they just commoditized. They have run a margin of a very small percentage and they don't make money. And your business is very well stable, very well placed. It's only, but even if it's 25-30% pet food is good because pet food gives you a lot of customers coming back regularly because it's a very monthly, weekly cycle for people to consume. So it is a loss leader. It gets you as a loss leader, more people coming in. But when they come in and they indulge themselves in doing it. And especially with the new pet parents, which actually get into that, they are more indulgent. Actually, they are normally, and now we're seeing a lot of, as you said, with nuclear families, you know, which have, you know, they're getting more into, you know, adopting pets. So I think that culture is, and yesterday Prime Minister endorsed it. So it is a big thing and it's a big opportunity. And I feel that the more awareness would grow, more this would grow. And B and C cities are fabulous opportunity. I mean, cities like Chandigarh, places like that, almost every second home has a pet, and there is a greater opportunity to do a store. So I'd like to invite now Sonia for your questions. And there is a question from Rishabh.
Thank you so much, Tanisha.
We do pet grooming. They do pet grooming. Over to you, Sonia.
Yeah. So I'd like to thank you. I think your presentation was very detailed. And I also agree, you know, there has been growing humanization by these pet parents, which are leading to the growing indulgence by many of them in this segment. And a higher referral and loyalty of customer base is another area I feel, which is very important in this category. And I was seeing some information. I saw some of your news on the media. And what actually prompted you was one of the tags which the actress, the Telugu actress, did on a social media on an appreciation. So, Misha, maybe for the audience, because I see some of them who just wanted to understand, you know, when you started, how you started. So, what was the reason behind, if you can just highlight that? And what success in the last number of years, ever since you've been operational, you've been able to achieve, is something I'd like to start off with.
The inspiration behind all this was mainly that to bring in the Western culture, or to bring in the luxury in pet stores, or to have a one-stop shop for all pet parents. Because when I went to US to meet my sister, actually, and that is where I had my first pet, and that is when I realized that we shopped more for him, and we didn't actually shop for us. We got all the things for him only. So that is when I realized that we lack all that in India. We don't have the luxury of buying fancy clothing or fancy bandanas or all those things, like all these accessories were not there at that time, like in India, and it was untapped. So I'm a fashion designer. I graduated in 2018. So I thought, why not use that skill in this industry? Because right now it's, like I said, it's untapped, and there's so much scope in India. So I wanted to try doing something different from the regular fashion designing that I could have done. But I thought, like, why not? Like, this is a great industry. And I love doing this. Like, I love designing clothes for pets. And there are so many clients who come up with different requests about their wedding, and they want something matching with their clothing, or some Garboni. We had a Garboni Choli collection for the Navratri season, and then we have a Christmas collection as well. So there are different things. There's so much creativity that is needed, and it's not like a normal clothing that you make. So I faced a difficult time to get my team together for that, because it's pet clothing. We had to find a very skilled master who can, you know, understand the body of the pet, how the hands come in, or how different detailing, like where the pet won't trip, or, you know, small things in which the accessory that we use, the buttons or anything, and how do you, the fastening, so that the pet should easily be able to get into it and out of it without, you know, troubling him. So all these small, small details is what
I also want to add about what Nimisha said about the tailors, that what one thing we've experienced, why we stress about the 20 member team, is that it is very difficult to convince the typical tailors that you have today to get into this segment, to hire them and train them. They will outright tell you, no, like, we do not want to do this. They do not want to train you, because of course, most of the tailors that we have right now are probably in a group of 45, 30, 40 to 60. And they do not want to try out a pet clothing. So we have a very dedicated team that has been doing this for over 2 years now. So that is why we our products are of great quality, because they're themselves willing to do it instead of just getting paid to do it. But like you said, the success mainly was boosted by Samantha ma'am's shopping with us for her pet, which really blew Instagram off.
Yeah.
We were bombarded with messages as to people asking for ma'am's number and all that, typical things. And it was great. And that's when we realized that we cannot work out of apartment anymore. We have to open a retail store. So that basically. And then again, like,
wonderful. I think that's a big.
Right. I'm sorry. You're saying something, ma'am?
Okay, I think that's a very big achievement in short span of time, and also the kind of products I saw. I was also reading about you in one of the news articles, which Telangana today also did on you. And I have some questions which I want to take up, because I also read that you've been doing a lot of customized clothing for marriages and occasions, which are also outside Hyderabad, including destination weddings like Goa, and you're giving to your clients based out of Chandigarh and Delhi and many other locations outside your city, which is Hyderabad. So, my first question, there are two to it. One, you already have an existing business in a lot of these cities, and if you have a franchisee coming up in these cities, do you have any kind of fulfillment being done by them, one? And second, because a lot of these products might also be customized, typical, how many days would it take for you to get this product to the destination?
So, the production normally takes a day or two. So that is the lead time for the production. Once it is dispatched, so we take a lead time at if the franchisee is in some other place, then it will take around 5 to 6 days for the delivery time, approximately, for a customization.
And at the moment we have, so we are now shifting our production unit to it was earlier restricted to 1,000 square feet. Now we are moving this to 3,000 square feet. This has been long due because the orders, we were trying to squeeze in everything. But as I said, retail, so the real estate is probably on a downside right now. So we got a dirt cheap price. We are moving to a retail, shifting our production to a 3,000 square feet outlet. So we can probably, hopefully, try to accomplish these orders in a day. Like, 1 day is what it'll take, 1 to 2 days is what it'll take for us to complete those orders. And our logistics, again, probably takes about 3 days.
Now, another question which I saw from one of our viewers also, do you see a possibility of shop-in-shop also, if somebody is running maybe a pet clinic or maybe similar complementing services? Do you foresee a shop-in-shop model which can be awarded to somebody who brings in his strength in this area?
Ma'am, are you talking about other different clinic and we put our products there? Or putting up a different a clinic into our store?
No, what she's saying is that there's somebody already running, say, a pet clinic.
Right.
And most of them don't do this kind of the kind of apparel particularly you do.
Right.
So if would you be open for a shop-in-shop kind of an opportunity if they are already running something and they bring you in and rest of the product, they can do it, which means that the food, they're doing it. But for all the accessories and everything, they only work with you.
Sir and ma'am, ma'am was talking about a success. I also want to add a point that we have reached this stage mainly because we have been going very wide in asking for the distribution. we started off by tying up with 2-3 distributors in Telangana who have put up our products, let's say 10-10, we give them, let's say 600 products. They put up 10-15 products at around 30-40 stores across Hyderabad. So that is when people from different parts of the city came to the store. That is why proximity plays a big role in the success of a retail store. And that did not really hinder our success because the products plays a different store and we have branding on it. We had them at different pet stores. Although we are still under contemplation and mostly we will be restricting this practice from now on because once we have a franchise coming in place, we want the Doggo products available only at Doggo stores. Now that we have, at least in Hyderabad, now that we have made a name out here, we want the exclusivity to remain with Doggo. Although it is a great practice and adds great things to our revenue, we want the brand to build and we will probably be now restricting like the products only to our specific stores instead of, you know, tying up with every store, having it at every store.
Yeah, I would like to add to that. So when we started out, we wanted our product to be tested. Like we wanted the clientele to understand or at least to use the product first to see what the quality is like, what the prints are like, how we are different from any other product. So that is why we started distribution. We are still doing it right now.
Yeah.
But like I said, we just want to reach the clients first. Once the product is out there, once the clients know what Doggo is and how good the quality is, they will be loyal clients. And by that time, we intend to have our franchisee there or we intend to have a shop nearby to those clients so that then the distribution will stop and then that will be like an advantage to the franchisee that the clientele will be dedicated to the Doggo shop only because that is where they'll get the products.
I'm not too sure if, you know, people have seen, is there a royalty which is also being charged on the total sales from the outlet? And if that, what percentage is that of the revenue which is charged to a franchisee?
Ma'am, there is a 6% royalty that is charged over all products except pet food because we recognize that pet food, like you'll notice, it's 25% margin share in the percentage. But pet food has very tight and very bleak margins. And we cannot expect a 6% royalty. And it is a very well-known fact that pet industry is very scattered. It is a very unregulated market. So there are a lot of pet stores running exorbitant discounts. And if unless you don't run a certain discount on pet food, it doesn't move. So we have totally taken into consideration that a pet retail outlet, a Doggo outlet will have to probably run a discount on pet food in order to compete with others. And like Gaurav said, that pet food is what brings customers back. So we will have to run these discounts on pet food. So the royalty for pet food depends on from brand to brand will be between 2-3%.
Yes, and also there are a lot of pet food has problem. There are a lot of discounting available. So, you know, that creates a big problem because there's a market operating price and some people, especially FMCG players, are using this as a, just as a commodity. So there's no margin really left. And while all the other products have a good margin. So as a loss leader, you take it, but real value, you really build it when people start buying a lot of other things, accessories, apparel, you know, grooming products and come for grooming. Grooming is a very big category. That's all margin because you only have to have maybe one good groomer and the rest becomes a margin. And especially for some pets, it's must to bring them out. You cannot obviously, and now because of hygiene and other things, people want to really bring into a pure grooming places rather than trying to do it at home and things of that nature.
Yes.
Great. So I think we had a good session. I should compliment both of you. You were fabulous. I think very, very well presented and very, you know, detailed oriented and also very passionate about what you do. I feel that you're building a great brand and there should be no rush in doing it. Selection of a partner is very important for you because who also sees the same value as you see. And slowly, I think the brand would be built. We are very excited for working with you and taking your you know, brand next level. So anybody who has an interest on taking the franchise or reaching out to them, please reach out to our hotline number. We will put the hotline number in this. Send a little detailed message. We will organize a detailed discussion with the company, and also organize I think Archana has already done that. I will start to do. So Archana has already put the hotline number. Please reach out this detail number, and we will in the coming this week itself try to do a discovery day. And in discovery day, we will take you on a little more detailed questions on what you want to do. And if you have your own shop and your own retail place, this can be a fabulous business for you. Fabulous business, because a long-term business, you don't have a pressure of rental, and you can get started very, very fast. So any last remarks you want to, both of you? I mean, any remarks from your side and then from Sonia?
I think just like to grow a business, like this is the right time to do it. I've been stressing upon that real estate is down, but when it's back, it's going to be back with a boom. So it's the right time to take up a good space. Rentals are going to be at the all-time low. So probably the best time to invest in a pet store, in a luxury pet store at the moment.
And because adoption and all is going on a different level right now because of the lockdown, I think by the time the franchisee is up and all running, the sales is just going to boom like in a few months actually. So
Absolutely. I think this is a very good time, a great time to build. So we have a lot of good interest, and if you have reaching out, you can like. So Sonia, your remarks?
I'd like to thank Bharat, you and Nimisha, you. And I personally feel it was a very honest presentation, very insightful. And I'm seeing a lot of questions which have come in. Some we have tried and replied. And there may be one particularly, Sandeep ji, I see you have a lot of questions that you want to ask, and perhaps he's looking for Bangalore, and we'll try and reach out to you after the webinar. We have taken your details, and maybe in this coming, in this week itself, we can take a rest of the questions which people have asked and get them on a direct interface with you. My only request to all of you is, friends, kindly put your location. If you have a property, do share details of the property, and also a little bit about what you're doing currently, your occupation, maybe your current interest. It'll help us in maybe profiling and getting maybe the time that you want to put on the call also productive for both the sides. So we'll come back to you, and we have put our hotline number for you. If you want to reach out, you can WhatsApp, or you can even call on that number. We'll take down details, and we'll filter all the profiles which are relevant, and we'll reach out to Ibadat and Nimisha for a call with you. So thank you. Ashna, over to you.
Thank you so much, friends and attendees who have attended today's webinar. Thank you so much, Ibadat. Thank you so much, Nimisha. I know the kind of the hard work you have put in yesterday, supporting all of us for presentation as well for video. We would like to extend our thanks to Sonia Ma'am and Gaurav sir also for sharing their insights about the industry, about the brand. You can reach out to us at our business hotline number, which is there on your chat box, which is 97176-83838. That's the number where you can go. You can share your suggestions, request, feedback, and your detailed profile with us. We'll definitely love to help you with all the related information. And you can also connect with Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am at their respective LinkedIn IDs. That's the information on your screen. But before you go, we are inviting you for tomorrow's webinar, which is happening. It's our 104th edition, and we are inviting team of Marshall, where Miss Mona Menon is coming and digitally interacting with you. The brand, which was established in 1975 and provides a complete range of home furnishing and interior solution. They are into wall covering segment. Do not miss this chance. Do registration today so that you can join us tomorrow for Marshall's webinar. Thank you so much for joining us today. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.